Hello all, and welcome to Geography class. We are going to look at a topic in Form 1, which is the Earth and the Solar System. And under this topic, we are going to look at a section which we call Structure of the Earth. Earth is made up of two structures. We have one, the external, external structure, and two, we have the internal structure. These are the two layers that makes up the structure of the Earth. If we can start with the external structure. External is also made up of two major layers. We have the atmosphere, and we also have the hydrosphere. Atmosphere and hydrosphere, they make up the external structure of the Earth. Atmosphere comes from the word atmos, which means air. So this is the air that surrounds our Earth. If I use my globe here, this is my Earth. The layer that surrounds the Earth is what you're calling atmosphere. Then we have the hydrosphere. Hydrosphere comes from the term hydro, which means water. So this is the area which is occupied by water. If I also use, I still use my globe here, these areas which are occupied by water gives us the layer that we are calling hydrosphere. In this layer, we have examples of water bodies, which includes oceans. We also have seas. We also have lakes. We also have swamps. We also have rivers, among others. All these make up the hydrosphere layer. That is the external structure, whereby you have said we have the atmosphere, and we also have the hydrosphere. In atmosphere, it is also made up of layers. Atmosphere has four layers. This air that you can see, we have layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, layer 4. Layer number 1, or atmosphere layer number 1, it is called troposphere. Then we have another one above it, we call it stratosphere. Then we have layer number 3, we call it mesosphere. And finally we have the layer number 4, which is very near the sun, we call it the thermosphere. It is very hot layer. Stratosphere, we also call it ozonosphere, because it is the layer that consists of ozone layer. If you look at the internal structure of the Earth, this is the part that is within or inside our Earth. If we open this globe, you will find it has layers. It has 3 layers down there. We have the outer one. We have the outer one. We also have another one here. And we also have another one in the middle. These are the internals. If we start with giving out the layers that makes up the internal structure of the earth, we have the outermost one, we call it lithosphere. Then we have another one in the middle, we call it as the noosphere, and we have the middle one or the inner one, we call it barysphere. Barysphere. Like that. Out of these layers, you will find they also have sub layers. For example, lithosphere here, it is made up of two layers. We have or two plates. We have one continental plate, and you also have oceanic plate. These are two layers of lithosphere. Continental plate makes up the landmass. We have continents. The term continental plate is coming from the term continents. We have the landmass or the continents. For example, Africa, we have North America, we have South America. There are seven plates. Then oceanic plates come from the term ocean. These are areas which are occupied by oceans. We have the likes of Pacific Ocean, we have Indian Ocean, among others. These plates, they are made up of different minerals. For example, this one, continental plate, is made up of minerals which are rich in silica and aluminium. And sometimes we call it sima. Sima coming from silica, C, and then aluminium. Aluminium, not sima, but Cr. Cr. Silica, C, and aluminium, R. We call it Cr. Then, oceanic plate is made up of minerals which are rich in silica and magnesium, coming up with a mineral which you call sima, from silica and ma, like that. Lithosphere, sometimes we do call it crust or earth crust. You might find other books calling it crust. Then before we look at our second layer here, if we can use our diagram here and draw our lithosphere, we have said it is the outer layer of the earth, like that. These are representing the continental plates, while these ones are representing the oceanic plates. Like that. Landmass or continental plates, and water bodies or hydrosphere or oceanic plates. This lithosphere is separated from mantle. This is my mantle, by a thin layer of discontinuity here, which we call morphologic discontinuity. It's a thin layer that separates crust from mantle. We call it morphologic discontinuity. Sometimes we can call it moho discontinuity or M discontinuity, or are correct. It's a thin layer that separates crust from man to. Then we look at our layer number two, which is as the noosphere. As the noosphere, it is also known as mantle. Mantle. So this is our layer number two. We call it as the noosphere or mantle. And this as the noosphere or mantle, it is also divided into two. We have the upper mantle. We have the upper mantle is here. Upper mantle, and we also have the inner mantle. Upper mantle and the lower mantle. These are two layers of mantle. And mantle, you can see, it is also rich in silicate rocks. So this one, as the noosphere, is rich in silicate rocks. Then, before you get to the third layer, barysphere, there is still another layer of discontinuity, a thin layer here of discontinuity that separates mantle from core, and this layer we call it Gartenberg discontinuity. We call it Gartenberg discontinuity. It separates as the noosphere and barysphere. Now we can look at the third one, third layer, which is barysphere. Sometimes we call it core or centrosphere, core or centrosphere. The same, it also has two layers. We have the inner core and the outer core. We have the inner core here, we have outer core, and you have the inner core, like that. Outer core and inner core. Inner core is rich in inner core, and then outer core. Inner core is rich in iron, mineral, while outer core is rich in iron and nickel. Iron and nickel minerals. So you find this inner core is rich in iron and nickel, while the outer core is rich in iron. So this is a structure of internal structure of the earth, but we can add the atmosphere here. We can add atmosphere here. Is the atmosphere, and these are the water bodies or the hydrosphere to come up with a structure of the earth. So this is the structure of the earth. As you have said, structure of the earth is made up of two structures. We have external and we have internal. External, you have said, has two layers, that is atmosphere, the air that covers the earth, and you have hydrosphere, the water bodies. Then the internal structure of the earth, you say we have three layers. You have lithosphere, or crust, hard crust, which has two layers, continental plate and oceanic plate. Then layer number two of the internal structure, you have asthenosphere, or mantle. And mantle, we have said, it is rich in silica. And the layer number three, we have barysphere or centrosphere or core. Sometimes you might find the other books talking of barysphere as the outer core, where centrosphere as the inner core. That's why it is from the term central, the inner most go. Some of the questions that you can find from this area is to identify the minerals that you can find in coal, in mantle, and you can also find another question to arrange the layers of atmosphere in order from the lowest to the highest, the layers of atmosphere, the likes of troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, and thermosphere. And with that, we can close at that point, and we wish you all the best there at home, and you take care. Thank you very much.